for a very special treat this year, as you very well know. For those of you who have not had the pleasure of meeting and hearing our good friend, Ragtime Bob Darch, I should just mention to you that, without exaggerating, Mr. Darch is probably one of the people most responsible for the revival of ragtime in the world, because at the time during the 1950s, when he was collecting ragtime sheet music, when other people weren't, in the years that he was personally going throughout the Midwest and reintroducing ragtime to the small towns of the Midwest, including Sedalia, and making these towns aware of their ragtime heritage. He was doing it on a personal basis, on a one-on-one relationship, by playing in theaters and saloons, in anywhere where he could play his ragtime. And over the years, he had a profound impact upon reestablishing ragtime. And through his very generous sharing of his ragtime sheet music collection, many young people like Traver Titchener's and myself and people who were collecting in those years had a chance to get copies of a lot of these very rare originals, which he had himself preserved. He was also very instrumental in contacting Joseph Lamb and preserving much of the music of Joseph Lamb, which will eventually see the light of day. So it's wonderful that all of those efforts have ended up in not only ragtime being preserved, very much thanks to his efforts, but he, of course, is still delighting audiences, not just in the Midwest, as he was then, but now all over the world. And he has just come back from a European tour and leaves Monday for Ireland. So we are indeed very fortunate to have one of the true great legends of ragtime, Ragtime Bob Darch.
Six non-stop from here to Buffalo. We're going to need a little something at the end of this thing to hold it down. It's a pleasure to be here, I might add. And Toronto has always held a warm spot in Toronto. It's a place that treated me very kindly right from the beginning. Through the efforts of Pierre Burton and his writings, the 76 Club existed and held on for about 6 years. Which was the ragtime place in town. And then Lewis came along down there with the Golden Nugget, and other places came out, the Silver Rail, and you can name it on and on and on. Do we have a little weight we can put on the end of this? Anyway, it's a pleasure to be here. I'm not going to deliver a big opus here, but just want to tell you how pleased I am to be here. I think it's been 9 years since I was here last. Seeing all my friends from Fort Faraway out there, Jim Kinnear and his wife Lewis. And it's been I don't want to do it. Is that your newest book?
Yeah.
That's great. Thank you. I'm always happy when it comes out right, too. That last note's a bar or something. Anyway, called the Georgia Camp meeting written by Kerry Mills in 1897, who went on to write such things as Meet Me in St. Louis, Louis, and other tunes that were very popular. A little tune this time, just to warm up on, was written by Irving Berlin in 1910, originally called Alexander and His Ragtime Clarionet. And in 1911, Ted Snyder, his publisher, told me how to change the lyrics, change the tune, to add anything in there, but to add some lyrics as well. And so it happened that that's what he did, under protest. And he said it was the best thing. When I talked to Berlin, he told me it was the best thing ever happened to him, that Snyder insisted that he change that tune around. It'll never sell as Alexander's Ragtime Clarionet, the old-fashioned spelling. So he changed it to Alexander's. He asked for, Snyder, he said, what the hell do you want me to put in there? And Snyder, also answering him back, said, well, I don't care. Swanee River played in ragtime. It mattered to me what you put in there, but put something in there. So he changed it. He said, best thing he ever did. He always thanked Snyder for insisting that he re-resurrect that tune from, they had, I think, 10,000 copies originally published it, and Snyder had 9,999 in his garage. Berlin bought the only copy. That's not quite true, a little story, but that's exactly what happened, and Berlin did change it around, and he wrote Alexander's Ragtime Band. He's lived so long, he's 99 years young today, and has the next birthday next February. 99 years young, sound of mind, but frail of body, and doesn't see anybody anymore. I can really say that he's a good friend, and more than an acquaintance. And I've met him about seven times in my lifetime. But anyhow, be that as it may. Alexander's Ragtime Band, and if you care to hear the Swanee River playing right.
Now let's see a little Susan. Thank you.
you very much. Right after that, I wrote Home for Money. A little tune this time written in 1913, entitled, I used to call her baby, but now... Vamped already. I used to call her baby, cause she was just a baby to me. When she said we should wed, I really felt glad. Took her home and introduced her to my dad. That's when I lost my baby. Dad, that's all that cash you see. She never even stopped to say ta-ta. Next thing I knew, she'd gone and married my pa. To think I used to call her baby. Well, now I have to call her mom. She was just a baby to me. When she said we should wed, I really felt glad. Took her home and introduced her to my dad. That's when I lost my baby. Dad, is all that cash you see. She never even stopped to say ta-ta. Next thing I knew, she'd gone and married my pa. I think I used to call her baby. Well, now I have to call.